Hi friends, welcome to my channel. This is Nisha here from Sri Kolhapuri, the doll factory, Chennai. Very happy to meet you all again through my doll making videos. I'm very happy to receive all your feedback regarding the doll making videos that I have been uploading. So after a short break, I'm starting again. Thank you for all the valuable feedback, suggestions, thank you notes and all. That makes my day very special. So today I am going to teach you how to make Andal doll with this in this small doll. Because I have received lots of questions. It is easy to make bigger dolls when comparing to small dolls, right? It is making small dolls is more difficult and time consuming. But I am going to teach you in a easiest and simplest way how we can decorate this beautiful doll. So let us see what are all the items required. This is just a 7 inch doll, approximately 7 inches height. I have the fabric, some lace items, hair, glue, scissors, needle and thread. The minimum items that we have today to decorate this doll. Step 1, I have tied a waist cloth around the waist. If you have a nada, you can tie a nada also. And the step 2, I'm going to teach you how to fix a blouse for this doll. Let us see how easily we can make this. I have taken lace which is matching to the lace that I have stitched in the fabric. So one small piece like this. So when you are pasting, I'm just going to paste it with the help of glue. So one small piece like this. This will help us ensure that we get a sleeve for the hand also. So fix it little cross so that we can close this sleeve portion. One portion like this and one portion like this. Next, I am going to take the same piece of cloth and paste it like this. You need to hold it tight. Blouse is ready. Now let us drape the sari. How to decorate Iyengar style bride doll, or how to make Andal, I have taken different videos. You can refer to those videos also. I will not be following all the steps because it is very small and the doll might look a little fat if I follow the full instructions for draping Madisar. So I am going to do it in a simple method. So the left side of the portion, I am taking small pleats here. And I am going to stitch it here. And this I am going to take it inside. And bring it like this. And then just one round. And the second round, I am taking it here. And this is how it is going to be. So let us see again. The first step is, I have taken small pleats here and I am going to put a stitch here. Second step, I am going to take this in between the legs and put a stitch here again. And I am putting a stitch here. I am going to put a stitch only for one, not the full material. Instead, I am going to give one stitch here with just a single layer. The next step is, this portion I am just going to bring it to the front, one round. and the other round I'm going to take it as a pallu. Take small pleats and put a stitch here. And the next step is this pallu portion. I am bringing it to the front and taking little bigger pleats, and this I am going to leave little loose here to give that traditional madisar look. So this portion should be little loose. You need not pull it like this. If you pull the, it will not give the traditional madisar look. So I am, this portion I am leaving little loose, and I am going to put a stitch here. Madisar is ready. So the same lace I have, with the help of glue I have fixed it here also to give that border pallu look. Next let's see how to fix the hair. Most of you are buying this type of hair from me, right? It is very easy. Other than the Velcro hair, I prefer this for small dolls. It is easy. What you need to do is, if you just open this, you will find a thread inside. Right? This thread, pull this and cut it. You will get the hair like this. What you need to do is, spread this hair, gently spread this, and this will give a beautiful wavy look. If you have a brush comb, the baby comb, right? If you have that, you can comb it with that baby comb. It will give the natural look. So I have just spread it like this. It is very easy and simple to use. What you need to do is, I have not, if you remove all this hair, if there is a original hair in the doll, if you want you can remove that. I have not removed it fully, just for video purpose. So see, start applying from one portion. This is what you need to be very careful. Do not apply gum in the head full. So just apply in one portion and start. You just need to keep this hair gently. So without the gap, just keep applying gum and start from one direction and finish it off. See, it is very easy. So wherever visible, those areas you can fix it with glue at the end. So this is how you need to start fixing the hair. I have fixed hair. It is neat. Gently, if you start applying glue and start fixing it, it is very easy. For the plait, I am going to fix this hair itself. So take a measurement, an approximate measurement. I have applied glue and then want to keep it like this. You can use put a kunjalam or any decoration items. Let it get fixed. By the time we will decorate this easily. Let us see with minimum items how we can. I have this stone sheet here. Add a necklace first. Same stone I have used to make it as a necklace as well, bigger necklace. I'm going to use a multicolor stone. This decoration is, as I tell every time, that this decoration is completely up to you. So whatever available the stone, these are all these stones and these laces will be available in any Ari workshops or tailoring shops also. You can check with them where do, because I get lots of inquiries. I am in Chennai and I might not know in which shop it is available in your place. So look for tailors who do Ari work, embroidery work, etc. So these are actually used in the blouses or lehengas that are made for people like us, right? So these are the real high quality stone items. So you can ask for the nearby tailor or any lace stores to get details about these items. Okay, and the next I'm going to add a small pendant. And one more here. Okay. And then add bangles. For the bangle, I am going to use my multicolor stone. Next, let's decorate the head portion. Take measurements like this, and you can start fixing it. Andal doll is almost ready. So the measurement for this madisar would be 18 inches length. Length is 18 inches and the breadth is only 3.5 inches. I have made these types of small earrings. It is very easy in any sheet, cardboard sheet or canvas cloth. One bigger kundan stone and one smaller kundan stone. Just paste it and leave it for some time and cut the extra portions. Small earrings are ready. So I am going to paste this small earring for her. These are called as Thadangam in Tamil. I am not sure in other languages. So I like this type of earrings. You can put Andal Kondai or any decorations here. So the doll is almost ready. You can refer to my video on how to paint the eyes. So I will be doing that later and apply mehendi. Dolls are ready. Hope this video was helpful. Make your own beautiful dolls at home with limited items. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. And thank you for all your valuable feedback and comments. Keep watching my videos and share it with your friends and family who are interested in learning doll making. Happy doll making.